Okay, here I'm defining the subroutine, and after the subroutine, after defining the subroutine, I cannot write anything. Right? Same thing I'm writing here. Okay, we cannot write anything after the define of the subroutine. Okay, and here we can place 9 placeholders. Okay, ampersand 1, ampersand 2. Like that up to ampersand 9. Okay, only 9 inputs only we can take in the macros concept. Okay, only 9 inputs. But coming to the subroutines concept, there is no limitation. Okay, there is no limitation for the subroutines concept. Okay, and macros, sorry, it will, and macros will call the same program. So macros can call the same program only, but subroutine is not like that. Okay, so it can call from another program also. Okay, macro will be in this program only. Okay, if you define any macro, then you can call in this program only. Okay, we cannot call this from outside of the program. Okay, in any another program. Coming to the subroutine is not like that. Okay, so I can declare the subroutine in this program, and I can call the subroutine in the another program also. Okay, I will show you that one also. How can we call like that? Okay, so these are the definition. These are the differences between macros and subroutines concepts. Okay, so that is why maximum we will go for subroutines only. Okay, subroutines concept. Okay, fine. I will go for another example for this one. Okay, subroutines concept. I will go for another example. Okay, and here, so first of all, we have to call the subroutine, right? So first of all, calling, and after that one, definition, right? Now what I will do some calculation for that one. Okay, perform. I am giving something calculation 1 here, LC1 or something HJF1. I am taking HJF or add. Okay, HJF add means this is for addition. Okay, I am doing something addition in this one. Okay, perform name means subroutine I am calling here. Okay, perform name, and here using I have to take some variables here. Okay, I have to take some variables. Before that one, I will give some inputs here. Parameter p type I, p underscore a type I. Okay, p underscore b type I. Okay, and data C type I. Okay, 3 variables I am taking here. Okay, p underscore a is the input parameter, and p underscore b is the input parameter, and normal c is the normal variable here. Okay, and here using p underscore a. Okay, and p underscore b. Okay, something values I am taking here. P underscore A and P underscore B. I am taking something values here. Okay, these two are the input values. Okay, means if I execute the program at runtime, I am giving the values. For that reason, I am taking the values like this. Okay, P underscore A and P underscore B like that. And changing changing C here. Okay, changing C here means whatever the value is coming, C equal to A plus B, like that I am writing here, right? And the same for that one, I am writing changing C here. Okay, so here we have to declare the form. Okay, this is calling, that is okay. Okay, I am calling this one, but I have to declare this form. How can we declare this one? Okay, so click on save, save the program. And here subroutine name is coming here, right? SJF add is coming, right? Just double click on that one. Okay, double click on that one. See, it is asking you subroutine SJF add does not exist. Create new object. Yes, I want to create this one. Click on S button. Okay, and here it is asking two options. Okay, it is asking two options. Do you want to create this one in new include? Okay, so it will create one new include, and the definition we store in that include. But I don't want like that. I want to save the definition part in the same program only. Okay, in the main program only, I have to save. Click on save button. Click on OK. See here, automatically form name came here using p underscore p underscore b and p underscore c is coming here. 1 minute, I will. Here form name, and using it is coming automatically. Okay, automatically something variables are coming, p, p, a, and p, p, b, like that. Okay, here you can change these names also. Okay, you can change the names also, like, so how the values you are taking here, p underscore a, and here also I want to take p underscore b. Okay, and here I want to take c only. Okay, not p underscore c, just I am taking c only. Okay, how we were taking in the calling part, p underscore a, p underscore b, and c, the same way p underscore a, p underscore b, and c I am taking. Okay, click on save button, check it. Okay, here c equal to p underscore a plus p underscore b. Okay, p underscore a plus p underscore b. Here using and changing, two things are coming here. Okay, using and changing, two keywords I am using. Using means these are the two inputs. Okay, using means inputs. I am using these two inputs. By using these two inputs, I am getting something output. Okay, by using these two inputs, I am getting something output, that is a changing here. Okay, changing, just activate it. Okay, I am not displaying the data anywhere, right? So here I can display the data, write C. Okay, write C, just activate it. Okay, and keep the breakpoint here. Click on execute button. A equal to 11, 20. Okay, numbers I am giving here. Click on execute button. Okay, so the cursor came at perform. If I click on F5 button, it will go inside of the perform. Click on F5 button. Okay, so it is coming inside of the program. So P underscore E. Okay, this name is not fixed here. You can change anything. Okay, you can change anything. And C equal to A plus B, something value is coming. This is the changing value. Okay, C equal to changing value. Something output is coming here. That was the changing value. C equal to 31. Okay. Now executed something, 31 value is coming here. Okay, fine. Now I am declaring the perform in this program, right? Program name is that HJF something date and two. Okay. Now I will go for one more program. I will go for one more program slash o AC38. Okay. Here I am giving something program name three. Okay. Click on create button. Execute. This is for click on local object. So this is the program here, right? Now I am calling the subroutine here, perform. Okay, what is the name for the perform? HJF add. HJF add using something values I am passing, okay, 10, 20, changing C, data C type I am taking, okay, changing C, okay, in program, I think so, in program, what the program name, so this is the program name, right? Let us see, just save it, check it, how it will come. Okay, fill in operation. Okay, fine. I will remove this one first of all. Using something 10, 20, and changing C. Okay, now save it. Check it, activate it. Okay, keep the breakpoint here. Okay, you can see the report name is HJF 100 82020 and 3. Okay, the program last number is 3. Just execute this one. So if I click an F5 button, okay, if I click an F5 button, then it has to go to definition of this form. Okay, it has to go to definition of the form part. So the form is available in this program, ZHJF 100 82020_2. Okay, so the definition is available in this program. Okay, but the current program is last number is 3 here. Okay, program 3, but the definition is available in 2, program 2. Okay, let's click on F5 button. See, you can see here the program name is coming as 2, means it is going inside of the form, program and inside of that definition of the form. Okay, now click on F5 button. What is the C value here? Total 30 is coming. Click on F5 button, this is as usually, click on F7 button. See, it is coming, something value C is coming as C30. Okay, C equal to 30 is coming. Click on F8 button, 30 is displaying here. Okay, means I am declaring the subroutine in one program and I can call the sub program from different program also. Okay, I am declaring one subroutine or sub program in one program, same definition part. Okay, same definition part I am calling from different program also. Okay, so this is the subroutines concept. Okay, subroutines concept. And one more thing here, something local concept is there. I have discussed that one also here. Data A type. Otherwise, I can go directly perform. Form name is something HJF. Form name is HJF. Data. A type A. Okay. Data A type A.
and a equal to something 20, I'm giving value.
Okay, data a type a, I'm giving I value, and a equal to 20, I'm giving, okay, something value I'm giving. Okay, now I have to call this perform. How can we call perform AJF? Okay, perform AJF, and here end form. Okay, here perform, I'm calling the subroutine. Okay, and I am defining the subroutine at the end of the program. Okay, so you can do like this. You can declare, I mean, you can write perform form name, and after that one form name and end form. Okay, you can write like this. Otherwise, you can double click on the, you can double click on the subroutine program name. Okay, it is asking you subroutine AJF does not exist. Do you want to create it? Yes, I want to create it. So where do you want to create? So do you want to create in any another include? So you already know about include. Okay, include means this is a one more sub program. Okay, I don't want to do like that. I want to save in the same program only. Okay, the main program only. Click on copy. Okay, button. See, automatically it is adding at the end of the program. Okay, automatically it is adding at the end of the program. Okay, these are the comments. You can, if you want, you can remove this one. No problem. Okay, now here what I will do, a equal to 30 and write a. Okay, write a. See what will happen here. Okay, what will happen here? You just see this one. Save the program, check the program, and activate it. Okay, now I am executing the program here. See, the cursor is the 13th line. Okay, 13th line. If I click on F5 button, it will go inside of the program. All right, click on F5. So it is coming inside of the program. Actually, I have given a equal to 20. Okay, a equal to 20 is there. Before calling the program only, I am passing something a equal to 20, like that I am passing here 20. Okay, now in this form, okay, inside the form, in the declaration part, I am changing the value a equal to 30, like that I am overwriting. Okay, click on F5 button. So here a equal to 30 is coming here. Okay, a equal to 30, and click on F5 button. I'm displaying something data, and if I click on F5 button, it will come outside of the sub program. Okay, outside of the sub program. See here, total 30 is coming here. Okay, total 30 is coming. Okay, fine. So after perform also, I will write a. Okay, let us see now. Okay, the cursor is at perform 13th line. Okay, if I click on F5 button, then it will go inside of the sub program. Okay, inside of the sub program, click on F5 button. So it is coming to the 18th line. Okay, so actually I have given a equal to 20. Okay, a equal to 20 I have given before calling the subroutine. Okay, now I am changing that value. Okay, I am changing that value, a equal to 30, like that I am passing. Click on F5 button. In place of 20, the value is coming like 30. Okay, now click on F5 button. Okay, so if I click on F5 button, it will come outside of the sub program. Okay, click on F5. See, the cursor is coming to 14th line. Okay, 14th line, 14 line. Click on F5 button. This is not required. Click on F8 button. Total 30 is coming here. Okay, total 30 is coming here. Okay, now what I will do, I will take here local. Okay, local a. In the definition part, I am taking one more thing, local a. Let us see now. Just activate it. okay, and execute it. Okay, I am calling something sub program here. Okay, I am calling something sub program here, and before that one I am passing something value to the variable a. A equal to 20 I am passing. Click on F5 button. Okay, a equal to 30 is coming here. Okay, I am changing this one. Click on F5 button. See, a equal to 30 is coming here. Okay, in place of 20, 30 is coming. Now click on F5 button. So write a means 30 will display first of all. Okay, it will display 30 first of all. Now click on F5 button. Okay, so if I click on F5 button, it will come outside of the sub program. Okay, now see here the cursor came to 14th line and the value a equal to 20 is there. Okay, a equal to 20 is there. Why it is coming like that? See here in the definition part, I am taking one more thing, local a. Okay, local a. This is the global a. A equal to 20, I am passing something value, right? So it will be in the global level. Okay, and here local a. Local a means I am declaring one more local field, local variable a. That name also a here. Okay, for that one I am passing the name, the value as 30. Okay, after execution of this sub program, it is coming outside of the sub program. Okay, local value 30, but my cursor is in global level. It is in the main program. Okay, it is, the cursor is in the main program. So in the main program, I have given the value of a equal to 20. Okay, the main value I am giving the a value 20. The sub program I am taking one more local variable, that name is also a. Okay, so for that one I am giving the value 30. Okay, 30 will come in the sub program only. Okay, and the main program I have given 20, so the value is converting into 20 once again here. Okay, if you don't take this one, if you don't take local a, okay, if you don't take local a, then the value will be 30 only. Okay, if the cursor came to 14th line, then also the value will be 30 only, because I am giving the value here 30, but I have written local a. Okay, local a. So here only the value will be 30. If you come outside, the value will be not 30. Okay, whatever the value is given here, that value will come here. Okay, so this is the local concept, the subroutines concept. Okay, 30 and 20 is coming. Okay, 30 and 20. And one more thing. And here I will declare some more variables. Data b type I value 30 or something 80. Okay, and data c type I value 90. Okay, and here I will write a comma b comma c. Okay, now activate it. Click on execute button. Click on desktop 3 button. Okay, so if I click on F5 button, okay, if I click on F5 button, it will go inside of that one, inside of the sub program. Okay, so if I don't want to go inside of the program, then what I have to do, anyone? Okay, if I click on F5 button, it will go inside of the sub program, but I don't want to go inside of the sub program. Total sub program I have to execute at the time, then what I have to do, anyone?
Click on F6
button. Okay, if I click on F6 button, total sub program will execute at a time. Okay, fine. Now I am clicking on F5 button only. See, the cursor came to inside of the sub program. Okay, A and B and C. Okay, three variables I am taking here. A equal to 20 is there. Okay, A equal to 20 is there. 20 is coming here. Okay, in the main program I am giving the 20 as A. Okay, and B I am declaring the sub program. Okay, B I am declaring the sub program, and click on F5 button. Now the value is changing to 30. Okay, previously the value is 20 only. Now the value is converting to 30. Okay, now click on F5 button. Okay, so A, B, C values will display here. Okay, now write A is there. Okay, A equal to 20 is coming here. Okay, you already know why it is converting to 20 here. Okay, because I have taken here local a, Okay, so local A, I'm giving 30, and the main program A equal to 20. So 20 is converting here. Okay, and coming to B and C, the values are coming like yellow symbol here. Okay, yellow symbol here. What is the meaning of this symbol? Okay, so these variables are not in this current program. Okay, these variables are not declared in this current program. Okay, so that symbol is indicating like yellow symbol. Okay, so you can ask B and C are available in the same program only. Okay, same program only, but these two B and C I am declaring sub program. See here in this declaration part. Okay, in this declaration part I am declaring B and C. Okay, so this is not in the main program, this is the sub program. Okay, these variables are in this sub program, not in the main program. That is why the values are coming like this. Okay, in the yellow color it is coming. Okay, wherever it is, if you see the yellow color symbol means these variables are any work areas or internal tables or constants, whatever it is. Okay, if it is yellow symbol here like this, then it is not in this current program. Okay, the variable is not available in this current program. Maybe it is available in the another function module or any another subroutine definition part. Okay, or any another program or any another screen. Okay, maybe it will be like that. Okay, the current program is this one. Okay, ZHJF. Okay, 100820203. So in this program, okay, in the main program, the variables are not available. Okay, maybe in this program only I am defining one more sub program. Okay, so in that sub program it may contain, but in the main program it is not available. That is why it is coming like yellow symbol. Okay, fine. Now click on iPad button. So you already know about this one. Okay, so this is the subroutine concept. Okay. And anyone have doubt up to here, subroutines concept, or anyone is getting confusion here, how to define and how to call? Sorry, who is talking? I don't know exactly. And your voice also breaking. Sorry. No, your voice is breaking. Your voice is breaking. Can you ping your doubt in chat box? Anyone have doubt? Any other doubts? In the meantime, you can chat in the chat box. You can ping in the chat box. Okay, okay, so here I'm executing this program. Okay, I'm executing this program. The cursor is at 21 line. Okay, the cursor is at 21 line. Okay, now in this current 21 line, the something perform is there. Okay, perform is there, and if I click on F5 button, it will go inside of the sub program. Okay, it will go inside of the sub program, but I don't want to go inside of the sub program. So I want to execute total sub program at a time. Okay, I want to execute total sub program at a time, then I have to click on F6 button, right? So clicking on F6 button. Okay, and one record is coming in the internal table. Okay, one record is coming in the internal table now. Okay, so here also, actual parameters and formal parameters I will discuss it in the function module. Okay, so then you can understand a little bit easily compared to now. Okay, fine. So here the cursor is at 22nd line. Okay, the cursor is at 22nd line. If I click on F5 button, it will go inside. But I don't want to execute. I don't want to go inside of the subprogram. Okay, so I have to click on F6 button. Right, but instead of clicking on F6 button, unfortunately I clicked on F5 button. Okay, but now just assume here only 5 rows are there. Okay, 5 lines of code is there. Okay, but in real time you can get some hundreds of lines in this definition part. Okay, then I want to execute total 100 lines at a time. Okay, then I want to execute total lines at a time. Then what we have to do, anyone? Okay, the cursor is inside of the subprogram. I want to execute total subprogram at a time. Then what we have to do? Anyone?
Press
F7 button. Okay, so if I click on F7 button, so all the subprogram will execute at a time. Okay, all the subprogram will execute at a time. Okay, fine. Now I'm keeping the breakpoint here. Okay, now I'm keeping the breakpoint here. Okay, now the cursor is at 23 line. Okay, the cursor is at 23 line only. Now if I click on F5 button, it will go inside of that one. Okay, if I click on F5 button, it will go inside of that one. If I click on F6 button, total subprogram will execute at a time. Okay, if I click on F5 button, if I click on F6 button, total subprogram will execute at a time. Okay, now if I click on F7 button in this situation, okay, in this situation I will click on F7 button. I have kept the breakpoint at 25th line and I'm clicking on F7 button. Okay, F7 button, then what will happen? Anyone have idea? Okay, instead of clicking on F6 button, unfortunately I clicked on F7 button. Then what will happen? Anyone? See, I'm clicking on F. Sorry, Ganesh, I'm not able to hear you. Your mic is too lagging. Okay, I will discuss. I'm not able to hear you properly. See here, F7 button. Okay, so first of all, it will check. Okay, it will check. So the program is in subprogram or not. Okay, so the program is not in subprogram, it is in the main program only. The cursor is in main program only, it is not in subprogram. Okay, so if the cursor is not in subprogram, okay, if the program is not in subprogram, if the cursor is not in subprogram, then if I click on F7 button, total program will execute at a time. Okay, total program will execute at a time, so it won't check anything, is it a subprogram or main program, like that, it won't check anything. It will execute that program, either subprogram or main program, at a time it will execute. Okay, so I am clicking an F7 button. Okay, I am clicking an F7 button, but this is the main program only. Okay, this is the main program only. So if I click an F7 button, then it will execute all the program at a time only. But on breakpoint I kept here 25th line. Okay, if I click an F7 button, see here the cursor is coming to 25th line. Okay, the cursor is coming to 25th line. Okay, if the breakpoint is not available, okay, the breakpoint is not available, total program will execute at a time. Okay, you have to get to know these functionalities, okay, in the debugging, main debugging concepts. Okay, F5, F6, when we have to click on F5, when we have to click on F7, when we have to click on F8, if you know these things, so half of the debugging you get the knowledge. Okay, so F5 button. Okay, F5 button. Okay, if I click on F5 button, line by line execution, wherever it is. Okay, so wherever it is, in the main program, subprogram. Okay, subprogram means it may include or macro or subroutines or or function modules. Okay, whatever it is. So include or macros or subroutines or function modules. So whatever it is, it is a subprogramming only. Okay, it is a subprogramming only. These concepts are subprogram concept. Okay. So line by line execution it will come wherever it is. It is the main program or sub programs wherever it is. Line by line execution will come by clicking the F5 button. Okay. So coming to F6 button. Okay. Coming to F6 button. Then what will happen? Let us see. For that one also I will show you. Activate it and execute it. Okay, so this is the program. Okay, if I click an F5 button, okay, if I click an F5 button, it will go inside of the program, inside of the sub program. All right, so I'm clicking an F5 button. So the cursor came to the next line. Okay, now I'm clicking on a F6 button. Okay, F6 button. So if you click an F6 button, then it will check, is there any sub program or not? Okay, if there is no sub program, then it will work like F5 only. Okay, click an F6 button. Okay, if you click on F6 also, it is going to the next line only. Means it is working like F5 only. Okay, it is working like F5 only. Now once again click on F6 button. See, here also it is working like F6 only, I mean F5 only. Okay, so if you click on F6 button, then also it is going to the next line only. Okay, only one line it is executing because there is no sub programming. Okay, so only one line executing this one. Okay, click on F5 button. So once again, the cursor came to the main program and the cursor is at 22nd line. If I click on F6 button, okay, now this is a sub program. Okay, this is a sub program I am calling. Total sub program will call at a time and it will go to the next line. Okay, now I am keeping the cursor here. Click on F8 button. Now the cursor is at 28th line. Okay, now the cursor is at 28th line. If I click on F5 button, it will go to the next line. Okay, and if I click on F6 button, here also there is no sub program. Okay, there is no sub program. It will work like F5 button only. If I click on F6 button, then also it will work like F5 only because there is no sub program. Okay, there is no sub program. That is why it is working like F5. Okay, here also, if it is normal line or subroutine or sub program line. Okay, if it is sub program, total execute, total sub program will execute at a time. Okay, otherwise it will work like F5 only. Okay, if sub program is there, then it will execute total sub program at a time. If it is normal program, if it is normal executable line only, then it will work like F5 only. Okay, see, the class will continue tomorrow, not for today. Tomorrow I will continue. The class will discuss in 1 minute. Okay, otherwise I will discuss about this one tomorrow. Okay, F5, F6, F7, F8. Tomorrow I will discuss. Okay, then tomorrow we will meet at 6:30 a.m. Then by Jai Hind.